Have you ever wanted to automate calculating the distance between two points and even providing a link to Google directions on how to get from point A to point B? If so, stay with me for a few minutes and I'll show you exactly how to do this. We're going to have directions, a start and end in Monday, and then we're going to calculate the directions and get a link to the directions in Google Maps using make.com. The inspiration for this video came from a Facebook group called monday.com for small businesses. If you want to join that group, check out the link in the description. I will tell you they put up with zero spam and zero selling things. So it's a safe group to join if you just want some help with monday.com. My name is Andy O'Neill and I help entrepreneurs like you add automation to their business. Okay, so let's jump into building this. I've got monday.com right here open. I've created a new board for this purpose. We've got the item name, we have a pickup and a drop off, a distance and directions. The distance and directions we're going to calculate. All right, so we're going to calculate the distance from Union Station in Kansas City to Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City. It just happens to be Super Bowl Sunday, and I'm hoping the Chiefs will beat the 49ers later on today. Our pickup location, we're going to paste a valid location right there. And now our drop-off, I'm going to hold off on the drop-off because I want the automation we're going to build to run when drop-off is populated. So the first thing we're going to do is go to integrate, and we're going to type webhook, and we're going to click on webhook. Now right here, I want, when a column changes, send a webhook. So I'm going to add that to my board, and we have to create that webhook. Right here, webhooks. And I want a custom webhook. Now, I'm going to name this webhook the same thing as my scenario. I'm going to hit save. We're going to name our scenario at the same time. All right. We're going to copy this address, hit OK, and we're going to run once. And we're going to use another account. I'm going to paste this in here. I'm going to hit connect. We're going to get an error here because we have to go do something in our make scenario to tell Monday it's OK. We're going to use this link. So right here, we get a challenge. So what we need to do is go to webhooks, webhook response, and right here, and we're going to put that challenge in there right there. So we're saying, we're putting in a curly bracket, double quotes, challenge. We're closing the double quotes, putting a colon, double quote. We're mapping that challenge, the double quote, and close curly bracket. That is a little bit of JSON, and you don't have to understand it. Just put it in there just like that, and that will satisfy Monday's need to know that we're okay using this webhook. So I'm going to go back here and click connect, and now we go back here. Monday is happy. We sent that challenge back to them, and we can now use this webhook. You can delete this module now because we don't need it anymore. We're going to hit run, and now we're going to configure this. So when a column changes, sends a webhook. Now we want, I'm going to set this as drop off. So when the drop off changes from like blank to populated, it's going to run this scenario. And I'm going to click add to board, and we're done. So let's go back up here and let's select, let's see, we have this running. Let's add Arrowhead Stadium. Arrowhead Stadium right there in Kansas City. Now we have updated that and now our webhook ran. Now what we're going to do is add Google Maps right here, and we want to get directions. So here is our origin. We don't actually have the location data here, which is a shame. So what we're going to do, right click, we're going to add a module. We're going to type Monday. We'll click on Monday. And we're going to get an item. So I typed get an item right there. So I've selected my connection. If you've not used Monday before, you'll have to click add and authenticate with your Monday account. So the ID we're going to get is the pulse ID. Show parent, no. So show sub items, no. All right. And we don't have to put the board ID. It's going to get that pulse ID. So let's click this and let's copy this pulse ID. And then let's right click on the Monday and say run this module only and paste that in there and run. Now we have our data. Here's our mappable column values with our locations. So let's go back over to Google Maps, and our origin is going to be our pickup. So our pickup is right there. Let's go down here and map the text. This is the full text. And then our destination is going to be, where's our locate? Right there, it's hiding. And we're going to put the text in here, Arrowhead Stadium. And you can pick driving, walking, bicycle, transit. We'll leave driving. You could, unfortunately, you can't map that, so you would have to choose which one you want. All right, so we're going to click OK. Now we want to update. Column values of a specific item. So we're going to choose our board ID. My board is directions. And then our item ID, we're going to map. So you're going to flip that to map right here. And you can choose either the ID of this one, or you can use the pulse ID of our webhook. I'm going to use the ID here. And then I'm going to columns to change. And I'm going to change the distance. And the distance we're going to get here. And I'm going to add another item, and I'm going to do directions. And that's a link, and I believe it's URL map here. And then my text for that link is going to be driving directions. So we're going to hit OK. We'll test this and make sure I've got the right thing mapped. Mapping a little bit blind because we haven't run it. And the other thing we want to do, I'm going to stop. I'm going to say if address exists, because I'm going to run this. And I'm going to delete that address right here, and it's going to run this because it changed. But what I did is I put a filter here that said, if the address is blank, don't do anything. So that'll save this trying to run, and it'll create a bunch of errors. So I'm going to run once again for Arrowhead Stadium. All right. So that scenario should be running, and we've got driving directions. Let's see what that looks like. Yep, that looks right. There's driving directions from Union Station to Arrowhead. And that is not 15,000 miles. I've driven that before and it's not that. So we're going to have to fix our scenario. Let's look at our data here. Distance. So we have distance in kilometers. Let's see here. Units. So let's change units to empirical. There we go. Now I'm going to remap this. So our distance is going to be this right here, 15.8. Okay, let's save that. Let's run this again. We'll get rid of Arrowhead Stadium, which will cause that to run. We'll go back here. Let's run this, and it's going to run again. It's going to update our values. Oh, we have an error. Okay, I think our distance. So that is a text value, and it's sending the miles. We have, this is a number column. So the number's not going to let miles come in here. Let's just delete this column. We're going to add a new one that is text. We're going to call that distance. Now we'll get that mapped correctly. We're learning together on this. Hey. I don't mind to show you that I make mistakes sometimes. All right, so the distance miles, that's why I changed it so we get the right one. And distance text. Yep, that's the right text. All right, now we have it. Run. Let's get rid of that again. Let's run this again. Go back to Arrowhead Stadium. There we go, 9.8 miles. And here's our driving directions. So here's the scenario to do this. It's four steps. If you want to do this for free, the free plan will let you run this scenario 250 times. Thanks for watching. And if you don't mind, give me a thumbs up and consider subscribing. Also, speaking of subscribing, I have an email newsletter that I send out on Tuesdays. You can subscribe to that, and I will see you in your inbox. Thanks for watching.